I've listened to this so many times. I still don't understand the plot.
Welcome to DNR Music. So today we're going to be doing Change It Up. We're going to be doing...
I don't have an answer for that. Is there something else I can help with?
No. Okay, so anyway, we're going to be doing Tommy by The Who. We're going to mix it up. I like this album.
So I remember when you were wanting this album, there was some other version of Tommy that you either didn't want or already had or something. What is the difference in the version?
This is the album. The other one's the soundtrack.
Oh, okay. And is one... Does the soundtrack have, like, more instrumental songs. Stuff on
more
it,
more songs, instrumentals by celebrities.
Okay.
And this record, I got it a few... less than a month ago, and it's already ripped. Anyway, let's start with the first song, Overture. This is a rock opera, one of its first of its kind.
So how many discs is this?
Two.
It's just two discs, okay.
So getting, I think this was apparently a Broadway musical. I've actually played a Tommy Pinball back in our Rock and Roll Hall of Fame video. That was fun. Then we have It's a Boy. This is more of a short one.
So does this tell a complete story then, this whole album? Do you know the story?
Yeah, I'm gonna explain it to you.
Okay.
Now. So Tommy Walker's a boy, he's average, and then he sees a murder and he becomes deaf, dumb, and blind, and nobody likes him, so then he apparently plays pinball, and then, like, everybody likes him, and I think so.
Okay. That is quite the summation.
Then we have 1921, because apparently this was 1921.
That's when this took place.
I think it's gonna be a good year.
Especially if you and me sit in
the record actually shortened some of these, like Overture. It's 5 minutes and 20 seconds on there, but it's 3 minutes and 20 seconds. Short them. Same with this next one. It's 5 minutes 4 seconds on here, but here it's 3 minutes and 25 seconds.
Did they just break it up differently? Because, like, It's
for
a Boy
record.
Is only 38 seconds here, and it's 2 minutes there.
I don't know. Are they combining it? I don't know. I'm confused.
Because that would be 5:57, and those two could be 5:58 combined.
Maybe, I don't know. It's going on an amazing journey, I guess. And then we have Sparks. This is just an instrumental one.
So did, like, people act this out, or?
Yeah, for, like, the musical prop.
Like when it was originally performed by The Who?
Oh, no.
No, they just performed the music.
And they played some other hits. We have Eyesight to the Blind, aka The Hawker. This is the only song they didn't write. This was written by Sonny Boy Williams II. So I guess it's like a cover of like an old blues one, and then I guess it fitted to the song.
Interesting.
Then we have Christmas. I count this as a Christmas song.
I can see why.
Then we have the Tommy Can Hear Me, which part which goes along way over the musical. Or opera. Same with the See Me Feel Me part. Then we have Cousin Kevin. So this one's about, his cousin Kevin wants to play with him, but he can't because, I don't know, he's, like, not capable. Then we have the Acid Queen, which in the movie, Tina Turner played this.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she has died.
Yes.
Then we have Undertale, which is 10 minutes and 4 seconds.
Oh,
it's around
wow.
that length, too. It's another instrumental one. Do we have Duke, You Think It's Alright? With his uncle. And there's Fiddle About, which is sung by and played by Keith Moon.
Oh, okay.
And there's some version with celebrities, other celebrities, and Ringo actually does it. Then we have the famous Pinball Wizard, which in the movie is played by Elton John, and he actually has a version of that on his album Caribou.
Oh. Yes. Obviously familiar with this one. So far, it's the only one I recognize.
Filling out a doctor because they think they can cure him. I feel like this one sounds like a song a Paul would sing. Like North of My Dear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it does have similar sound.
And then we have Go to the Moon. They have the See Me, Feel Me, and if he goes to the mirror, will he be able to see and everything like that? Then we have Tommy Can You Hear Me, which is the actual song of the part that repeats from time. Tommy, can you hear me? Favorite part? It's just that Tommy. So pizza. We have Smash the Mirror. So it didn't really work, so it's smashing it, my guess. Then we have Sensation. You feel me coming. Because he's good at pinball, I guess he's a sensation. Then we have a 12-second miracle cure. But since it doesn't have any listens, but I doubt that.
Right.
They just do that with short songs. Then we have Sally Simpson.
Who's Sally Simpson?
I don't know. I've listened to this so many times and still don't understand the plot. We have I'm Free. We have Welcome. This one I feel like is kind of out of place. It's more of a slower one about welcoming. But who are we? Is Tommy welcoming people? Is who? Is, we have another Keith Moon song that Ringo also sang in that thing I was talking about. Tommy's Holiday Camp. He's starting a summer camp. Okay. That's what it's called, Holiday.
Sure.
Then we have We're Not Gonna Take It. This is actually a lot, like three songs into one. There's We're Not Gonna Take It, See Me, Feel Me, and Listening to You.
Will it end on like high energy or?
Yeah, kind of. I think See Me, Feel Me was the B-side to a single from it. Then Listening to You. So it ends on, it's a fade out, but it ends on high energy.
Gotcha.
So there you have it. Like, subscribe, follow the Instagram. Yeah.